Pittsburgh is a popular city because of its rich industrial history, beloved sports teams, and more. If you haven't yet been tempted to visit, you may not realize all it has to offer. The city has everything you could want, from bustling urban areas to quiet parks. So keep watching to learn about all the best things to do in Pittsburgh, PA. Duquesne and Klein. Pittsburgh residents needed a way to get from their homes on the top of hills to the mills and factories where they worked on the bottom. Before cars became popular, they used inclines like this one, which has been in operation since the 1870s. It was restored in 1963 and has become a popular spot for visitors. It's over 140 years old and offers skyline views and perfect photo opportunities. It also has restaurants to eat at and a museum and gift shop where you can learn more about and take home mementos of its rich history. Randyland. Randy Gibson hosts this exhibition of art made with repurposed trash. He purchased the two colorful buildings in 1995 with a credit card. Admission is free, and it's open 7 days a week except December 24th to 26th for the Christmas holiday. Phipps Conservatory. This is one of the best spots to experience natural beauty in Pittsburgh. You can gaze at its perennial flowers all year. There's a collection of green rooms focusing on a region or plant types, such as tropical forests, butterfly gardens, or bonsai trees. You can also come for its seasonal flower shows, two of the best of which are the Spring Flower Show from March to April and the Winter Flower Show from November to January. You can even rent it for a wedding. And it's a wonderful place for students from the two nearby universities to come and relax. Children can enjoy the hands-on activities and play areas. Admission is $17.95 for adults and $11.95 for children. And the conservatory is open from 9:30 to 5 every day, with extended hours on Friday. Strip District. This former industrial neighborhood now packs plenty of attractions into its half a square mile space. It has restaurants, international markets, museums, shops, and more. Most are family-owned. A few of the best food offerings are Pimonti Brothers French Fry Topped Sandwiches, breakfast at DeLuca's Diner, and pancakes from Pamela's P&G Diner. A few of its non-restaurant vendors close at around 3 p.m., so be sure to come early. Andy Warhol Museum. Andy Warhol is one of the most famous artists of all time, and since he grew up in Pittsburgh, this museum is dedicated to his work. It's the largest single artist museum in the U.S., with 7 floors of installations, reproductions, and educational exhibits. One of its best is the Cloud Room. It also hosts rotating exhibits and a range of daily and weekly events. Admission is somewhat high, but it's a price worth paying for fans of the artist. Point State Park. This park spreads over 36 acres. It sits at water level and provides views of the nearby riverboats, Mount Washington, and PNC Park. It also features a large fountain and the outline of the former Fort Duquesne. You can also visit the Fort Pitt Museum to learn about the park's history as the site of Fort Pitt in the 18th century during the American Revolution and French and Indian War. Senator John Hines History Center. This museum focuses on the history of the city of Pittsburgh. Its exhibits are spread over 6 floors and detail its early settlements, sports, local inventions, and more, including how it moved into the modern day. Carnegie Science Center and Carnegie Museums of Art and Natural History. There are 4 Carnegie Museums in Pittsburgh. The Science Center is separate from the Museums of Art and Natural History. It features a planetarium and exploration station, a sports-focused venue, robotics exhibits, a submarine, and more. The entertainment comes from more than just the exhibits. You can enjoy laser shows and screenings at the Rongos Omnimax Theater as well. The Museums of Art and Natural History sit in the same building, and you only need 1 ticket to visit them both. You'll enjoy dozens of rooms full of art and natural history exhibits, including dinosaurs in their time, the Hillman Hall of Gems and Minerals, and the Hall of Architecture. Falling Water. Frank Lloyd Wright built this spot on the Laurel Highlands in the 1930s for a department store owner. It's perched over a waterfall with plenty to see as long as you don't mind a drive and can book tickets several weeks in advance. Carey Furnaces. This spot in Rankin is only open from late spring to early fall, but it's worth visiting. It's one of the last remaining blast furnaces and also serves as a museum commemorating Pittsburgh's contributions to the steel industry. You can take a tour of the grounds with a botanist or a guided tour of the machine shop, but be sure to get reservations in advance. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to Viewcation if you haven't already. And stick around for a lot more of the best of Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh Zoo and PPG Aquarium. Both these spots in the Shadyside neighborhood are perfect attraction for families. Both these spots in the Shadyside neighborhood are perfect attractions for families. The zoo houses over 400 animals and has a kids' kingdom with a petting zoo. The aquarium has a stingray tank and a wide range of marine species. PNC Park. This is the home field for the Pittsburgh Pirates. Visit on game days and get local craft beers to drink and hot dogs or pierogies to eat. Visit on a fireworks night for a dazzling display. There's also plenty to do outside the park. Heinz Field. This attraction houses the Pittsburgh Steelers. It's built on a waterfront that offers spectacular views, but it also doubles as an event space for concerts and other acts. Tickets are fairly pricey, but touring the field anytime from April to October is more affordable at only $8 for adults and $7 for seniors and children. For 90 minutes, you'll be guided through its most notable sights and be able to take photos with the river backdrop behind you. Three Rivers Heritage Trail. Over 500,000 visitors and Pittsburgh residents use this trail every year. You can traverse the 24-mile-long path on foot or on a bike or roller skates. You'll pass by several other notable attractions like the Andy Warhol Museum, PNC Park, Heinz Field, and Point State Park. Kennywood. This is one of the best amusement parks in Pittsburgh and one of the largest at 150 acres. It's also one of only two amusement parks to ever be given the honor of becoming a National Historic Landmark. It began as a trolley park in 1898, built to entertain mill workers, but now provides nostalgic fun for everyone. Fans love its most historic rides, such as the Thunderbolt, built in 1924, and the Turtle, built in 27. It offers water rides such as the Pittsburgh Plunge and huge roller coasters like the Phantom's Revenge, which offers a 230-foot drop. It also has a kiddie land for those too young to go on the larger, more intense rides. Market Square. This open public space used to house the city's first courthouse and jail. It's now a common place for meetings and events. A few of the most notable are the summer farmers markets, outdoor yoga and dance classes, and the bi-weekly kids play. Mattress Factory. This three-building museum in the north side brought life back to several abandoned buildings. It was established in 1977 and now features contemporary art exhibits housed in three buildings. Two of the most popular exhibits are the Repetitive Vision and Infinity Dots Mirror Room. The art on display rotates, giving you a reason to return, but be aware not everything is child-friendly. PNC Carousel. This attraction in Schenley Park is open from April to October. It was built in 1913 and moved to its current location in 2006. Its Victorian-style architecture, bright colors, and traditional organ music make it unique. Take a ride for only $2 or get a family season pass. Bar 11. This bar gives you something no other can, a toy with every drink. You may get a finger trap, candy necklace, rubber duck, or any number of fun distractions. Even if you're not into the toys, Bar 11 has a great atmosphere for you to enjoy. Liberty Magic. This spot on Liberty Avenue hosts magicians every month who show off a range of talents from close-up magic to magic-infused stand-up comedy. It's BYOB, but dressing up in cocktail attire and enjoying a drink makes it even more fun and helps you get into the speakeasy feel that the location gives off. The Original Oyster House. This is the oldest restaurant in Pittsburgh, and that's saying something when speaking about such a historic city. It opened in 1870 and was designated a historic landmark. Old photos and memorabilia line the walls, but nostalgia and historic appeal isn't the only reason to visit. It also offers delicious food, which includes, as you may expect, fried oysters. The Big Mac Museum. The famous Big Mac sandwich was invented by Pittsburgh resident Jim M.J. Delligatti. This museum, dedicated to his contribution to the world of fast food, seats 122 people and features a play place, McDonald's memorabilia, and a statue of the creator. Hofbräuhaus. This restaurant mimics the famous brewhouses of Germany with beer, live polka bands, and servers dressed in traditional lederhosen. It also offers views of the nearby river and a beer garden if you want to eat outside. Trundle Manor and the Weeping Glass. Trundle Manor in Swissvale looks like an average house until you enter it. It houses coffins, medical devices, and other morbid oddities. It relies on donations of either money or new items to exhibit. The Weeping Glass is more of a gift shop than a museum where you can purchase similarly odd items. Have your tarot cards read or watch this month's Midnight Death Parlor performance. Canton Avenue. A maximum grade of 37% makes this the steepest street in the US. You can drive up and down it, but only the strongest cyclists should take it on. Church Brew Works. St. John the Baptist Church was converted into a bar. Vats of beer sit on the former altar, and you can enjoy them while sitting on former pews. It's only one of Pittsburgh's historic buildings that were turned into bars. Others include the Abbey, a former funeral parlor, and the Ace Hotel, a former YMCA. Bob's Garage. This spot is also known as the Christmas Bar thanks to its holiday lights and decor, but changes its theme with every season. This gives it an inviting atmosphere, and the sandwiches and burgers on its menu are also worth experiencing. Roberto Clemente Museum. This former engine house is now a museum dedicated to the most famous baseball player to ever come out of Pittsburgh. Roberto Clemente joined the Pirates in 1954 and rose to fame not only as a great player, but also as a dedicated humanitarian who died in a plane crash on his way to help earthquake victims in Nicaragua. The museum features a range of baseball artifacts. Invention Land. This site spreads over 60,000 square feet, and it needs that space to show off all the important inventions to come out of Pittsburgh, including the polio vaccine, the Big Mac, and Heinz ketchup. It used to be a workshop, but now hosts a range of exhibits and work areas for future inventors. You can also join a tour, but no flash photography. Prannitz Bakery. This spot claims that its burnt almond torte is the greatest cake in America. Visit and judge for yourself, and be sure to try its other delicacies, such as any of its over 60 flavors of Kaufman's Thumbprints cookies. Grand View Park. This spot offers one of the best views of Pittsburgh's landscape. It also hosts movies and music festivals in the summer. Games and At. This game emporium calls itself a Pittsburgh thing. It hosts a range of activities, including duck pin bowling, video arcades, pinball, foosball, skee ball, and more. It's also a perfect place for the whole family, with adults allowed to bring their own beer. Sup Three Rivers, Surfs Up Adventures, and Stand Up Pittsburgh. Stand-up paddleboarding is one of the best ways to experience Pittsburgh's three rivers. All these locations will teach you how to do it. Banjo and Bluegrass Night. This popular event has been held every Wednesday at the Elks Lodge for 30 years. It features great music and delicious food and drinks. It's so popular, you should get reservations in advance. Mineo's and Aiello's Pizza. These two shops sit a few doors down from each other, but have been rivals for decades. Most Pittsburgh residents have their opinions on which is better, but you should visit them both and make your own decision. Construction Junction. This large warehouse features recycled materials and appliances. You can purchase them at reduced prices and get everything you need for your DIY projects, or just browse the impressive selection. Allegheny Wine Mixer. This Upper Lawrenceville bar is modeled after the 2008 comedy Step Brothers. It features incredible Hulk hands above the bar, cheese toasties, and drinks with names like Boats and Hose. It's a must-see for fans of the film and a great place for anyone to get a drink. Mellon Park Walled Garden. Artist Janet Zweig built an art installation in this park. It was a tribute to Anne Catherine Siemens, an artist, dancer, and ceramist who visited it often before dying in a car accident at age 19 in 1999. It features fiber optic stars that cast the pattern of the sky onto the day of Anne's birth. Arcade Comedy Theater. This spot offers comedy shows every weekend. It also hosts improv pop-up night every third Thursday of the month, where you can take a 2.5-hour class on improv comedy. Square Cafe. This Braddock Avenue diner is the place to go if you want to enjoy a quality brunch. It also features local artwork and ceramic square mugs for your coffee. Try its unique dishes, such as smoked salmon crepes, lemon berry ricotta pancakes, or Brussels sprouts bowls. Jerry's Records. This spot earned the designation of one of the best record stores in the United States. It houses over 500,000 albums, and viewing them is like being transported back to the past. Now it's time to hear from you. If you've already visited Pittsburgh before, what was first on your list of things to do? Let us know in the comments section below. And before you go, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to Vucation for more. Click the bell icon to stay updated on all our latest content.